Good afternoon, Vinay Mal. Welcome to the video lecture of Construction Technology. Today we are going to discuss about whitewashing, distempering, damproof course and termite proofing from fourth module. This is the last video lecture on fourth module. Till now, in fourth module, we have discussed about the different types of arches, lintels, floor and floor covering materials, roof and roof covering material, plastering, ventilators, pointing and painting. Now we are moving on to whitewashing, distempering, DPC and termite proofing. At the end of the slides there will be assignment question. You need to work it out. Moving on to the next slide. Start with, in this session we will be discussing about what is whitewashing, color washing, what is distempering, what are the process involved in distempering, what is DPC, what are the causes and effects of dampness, what are the materials and methods of damp proofing and what is termite proofing. Of these topics, distempering is very important. It was asked for previous year university questions, and damproof coursing is another important topic. The methods of damproof coursing was asked for previous year question papers many times, so you need to study these topics thoroughly. Moving on to our first topic, whitewashing and color washing. Whitewashing or color wash is applied on plastered surfaces. Whitewashing and color washing of building surfaces is necessary on both hygienic and aesthetic reasons. It is an inexpensive surface finish that is commonly used in rural areas. Usually, for whitewashing, fat lime is dissolved in large drum. It is creamed to clean coarse cloth up to 24 hours. Gum is added, and in case of color washing, pigments are added into it and it is usually applied in 3 coats. This is all about whitewashing. It is applied on plastered surfaces and these are the points related to whitewashing. Moving on to our most important topic, distemper. First of all, we shall understand what a distemper is. Distempers are cheaper variety of paints with chalk as base, water as carrier and emulsifying agents in the form of glue or casing. It is applied in 2 coats. Moving on to the properties of distempers, they are light in color, thicker coats can be applied, they give a reflective coating. They are less durable compared to paints, they are cheaper, they exhibit a poor workability and they cannot be used in damp locations. The process of distempering include preparation of surface, application of priming coat and the coats of distemper. We need to know this in detail. Moving on to the most important topic, damp proofing. Damp proofing means the prevention of penetration of moisture into buildings through walls, floors, roofs, etc. First of all, we shall understand what are the causes of dampness in buildings. The major causes are moisture from ground, splashing of rain, exposed to top of wall, condensation and construction defects. The effect of this dampness include patches on walls, softening and crumbling of plaster, damage of decorative finishes, damage of floor finish, deterioration of timber finishes, corrosion of metal components and the damage of electric fittings. Then the requirements of damp proofing material. While we are selecting damp proof materials, we should be very careful because it should be impervious, like in the case of plastic sheets or bituminous felt. It should be durable with lifespan as long as that of a building. We know that for a normal concrete building, the lifespan is 70 to 100 years. It should be that durable. It should be capable of bearing the load imposed on them. It should be dimensionally stable. It should remain as such even under the application of load. It should be flexible. It should be free from sulfates, chlorides and nitrates, because these compounds react with the components of building. It should be inexpensive. Moving on to the materials for damp proofing. Commonly used materials are hot bitumen, mastic asphalt, bituminous felt, metal sheets, combination of sheets and felts, plastic sheets, bricks, mortar and cement concrete course. Let's look into it. As you can see here, this is hot bitumen which is applied in the basement. This is mastic asphalt, same as the case of hot bitumen, it is applied in layers. This is bituminous felt, available in sheets. This is metal sheets. These are plastic sheets, that is highly impermeable. Then the bricks, mortar and cement concrete course, you are familiar with these terms. Moving on to our next topic, termite proofing. We might have seen our woodwork, furniture, etc. damaged by white ants. These need to be prevented. So anti-termite treatment is required for wood and furnishing. This is generally termed as termite proofing. Before moving on to the topic, we need to understand about the type of termites. There are basically two types of termites. They are ground nesting termites and dry wood termites. Ground nesting termites always maintain connection with soil. They consume wood and these are found in all regions of India. Dry wood termites live in wood without any connection with the soil. The commonly used chemicals for anti-termite treatment are chlorpyrifos concentrate, heptachlor concentrate and chlordane concentrate. And you might have heard about aldrin, DDT, etc. These are chemicals, but they cause health hazard to humans, so these are not much preferable. Moving on to the termite processing stages, it can be conducted in pre-construction and post-construction stage. And in pre-construction stage, the different steps involved are, first of all, termite hills are sprayed with chemicals. Then the bottom and sides up to a depth of 300 mm is treated with chemicals. Then earth is being filled and it is treated with chemicals. After filling, deep holes are drilled and it is treated with chemicals. Junctions are the crucial point. They are sprayed with chemicals. Afterwards, the holes are filled and the expansion joints are again treated with chemicals. Doors and window posts, which is in contact with the masonry, are coated with two layers of paint in order to avoid the termites. In the post-construction stage, pressure pumps are required for proper chemical penetration. It is carried out in three stages, outside walls around the building. It is pumped with chemicals at the rate of 5 liters per meter, soil under the floor and treatment at plinth level, all using holes of 12 mm diameter. Moving on to the previous year questions. The previous year questions include, explain distempering as we have learned, explain any one damp proofing method, what is DPC, explain different methods to provide DPC in residential building. By the end of the session, you might be familiar with what is whitewashing, what is color washing, what is distempering, and what are the various materials used for distempering. Then damp proofing, what are the requirements of damp proofing, what are the various materials used for damp proofing, then termite proofing, what are the stages involved in termite proofing. By now knowing all this, you can apply it practically as well as for your examination. These are the previous year questions asked from this topic of study, and you should answer it properly to get the required marks. Moving on to your today's assignment topic, in damp proofing we only discussed about the various materials used for damp proofing. We didn't discuss about the methods of damp proofing, so we need to discuss about the methods. So methods of damp proofing, the damp proofing is done in different stages at different parts, that is treatment of foundation, treatment of basement, treatment to floors, treatment to walls, and treatment to flat roofs. So you need to know what are the steps followed in each of these stages. You should do it as assignment. You should search net. You should get details from your textbooks and prepare the assignments. Afterwards, we'll be discussing this in our session. Thank you for listening to the session. Be safe.